Going to solve by the quadratic formula. First off, what is the quadratic formula? Well, that's negative b plus or minus square root b squared minus 4ac all over 2a, to the tune of pop goes the weasel. And a is 3, b is 2, and c is negative 12. So I'm simply going to plug these values in. Notice for the b's, I put a 2. For the a's, I put the 3. And for the c, I put a negative 12. And be careful here because this is the opposite of your b. So it's opposite of 2, which is negative 2. 2 squared is 4. And negative 4 times 3 is a negative 12. And negative 12 times negative 12 makes a positive 144. And 2 times 3 is 6. I can add the 4 and the 144 to make 148. Now, y'all, this will reduce. Now, I like going to my calculator and doing my little table thing with 148 divided by x squared because it's a little easier math than doing my factor tree and everything. If I go to my table, I'm going to look at the answer will be the last number without decimals. Now, I could keep going down, but they're all going to be decimals. But the last one without a decimal is 2 and 37. So the square root of 48 is basically 4 times 37, and the square root of 4 is 2. Now, because I have a 2, what I call on the outside the radicand, and a 2 here and a 6 here, there's all divisible by 2. I can reduce the outside numbers only, not the radicand. So I divide them all by 2. I have negative 1 plus or minus the 1 there, square root of 3, I mean over 3, the square root of 37 over 3, say it right eventually. And I don't have to write that once. Your answer would look like this here. This would be my x values, negative 1 plus or minus the square root of 37 divided by 3. And my axis of symmetry would be at x equals negative 1/3. Always is these numbers here. All right.